What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Tom here with EasyWeb 101, bringing you a video today that's a little bit different. Not that much different, but this is the first time you're seeing my face, so you actually get to see what I look like. So here I am. Anyways, so today we're going to be doing a video on Toonly. I've made some little videos on it previously. I made a video that showed the first time that I used it without really watching any tutorials or knowing anything about it, just so that you could see how, you know, if it was easy to use, user-friendly, that kind of stuff. I've also made a couple commercials with it now, and some of you may have seen those if you like and follow my Facebook. I've been posting a couple on those as well. If you don't like and follow my Facebook and don't subscribe to the YouTube channel, you should now so that you can see all this stuff. But anyway, so today we're going to do an actual tutorial on it, and I'm going to kind of show you a little bit more about how Toonly actually works and some of the stuff that I've discovered. Now, there are some great tutorials on Toonly's website as well that you can just follow those. But just in case you're looking for something a little bit extra, I'll go over all the basic features of it today. We'll make kind of a quick video, not a real, you know, commercial, but just something quick so you can kind of see how this works. So with that said, let's roll right into it. I'm gonna go ahead and shrink this screen down with me to somewhere around in that area. And this will bring us to the Toonly dashboard. So within Toonly here, we've got a couple different things going on. Let me explain the different windows here. So at the bottom, you have kind of your video editor where you can edit the lengths of how long, say, characters appear in a scene, how long the scene is going to be, or how long the audio is, modify the audio. It'll be pretty familiar to you if you've ever used video editing software before. If you haven't though, I will show you a little bit more about how that works. Over here, you can add additional scenes if your video is going to be broken up into multiple different kind of video scenes. That's where you can put multiple ones in. I haven't really had a need to use that yet, but I'm sure that there are some valid reasons for using it. Just for me, I'm just making quick 1 minute videos, so I don't know why I'd need a bunch of scenes. Anyways, okay, and then over here on the left hand side, you have all of your assets. So as far as assets go, we have scenes which are already completed, scenes that have characters already placed into them, they're already animated, the background's there, everything's already there. So it's meant to kind of help you get a quick start on the video. So you'll notice if we press play, there's already going to be some stuff going on in this video. There's a lot of different ones here. This one wasn't too advanced. They didn't really do a whole lot to do it. It looks like she does that. She holds up a camera, takes a picture, and that's about it. Now, if you need something more custom, you're not going to want to use a scene, you can go ahead and delete anything from here by just right-clicking, hitting remove. We're going to build our own little scene today. So let's go ahead and grab, say, the beach. So these are all your backgrounds for your scenes. You'll just drag and drop it into place. Everything in this editor is drag and drop, pretty much. So now we've got ourselves a nice little beach background. You can upload your own backgrounds if you want by clicking upload new object. You can do the same thing with the objects down here. This is where you can find objects to use in your video, say like this flower pot, if we wanted that in there somewhere or something like that. You can add those kind of things in. Today I feel like ice cream is a good idea, so I'm gonna drag a couple ice creams into place here. All right, so you got a couple objects, you got your background, you're going to want to grab a character for yourself. There's a bunch of different characters in here now. Not all of them have the same animation. So if you drag a character into place, say like this Superman, and then you're going to right click on him, and you'll see it pops up with animation settings, and you'll see he's only got really this and then just standing there. So you can either have him holding his hands on his waist like that or standing there. Not a whole lot that you can do with him. So if you pull in one of the characters and you find they only have a couple animations, you need something else, go ahead and grab another one. So I'm going to grab this guy, and you can see he's got lots of animations. He does all kinds of stuff. So With that said, we're going to go ahead and use him. He's going to represent me. That would totally be me if I went to the gym like a lot more and lost some weight and all that jazz. But anyways, okay. So basically, we'll come down here to the editor. We know the green is him because if we click on the green, it will highlight him up here. Vice versa, if you click on that here, it'll highlight an orange down there. So we know he's going to be throughout the whole scene. Now, depending on what exactly we want him to do, we're probably going to have him say hi initially. So we'll go ahead and have him saying hi. My plan is to make him just sit around and dream about ice cream. So if you need your character to do multiple actions, like I want him to say hi at first, and then I'm going to have him kind of dreaming. So we'll hit the plus sign next to his character line here, whatever you want to call it. And then we're going to go ahead and select another animation. There isn't really a dreaming, but I feel like thinking might be okay. And we'll drag that out for as long as we need. So say he's going to be thinking for, I don't know, 10 seconds or something through the whole scene. And the beach, we'll make the beach scene 10 seconds long. All right, so we've got him saying hi and thinking. Let's see how that looks so far. And then he switches to thinking. And we're going to change where the ice cream stuff is in just a second here, but we just wanted to get a rough idea how that looks, so you'll see how he switched himself there. By the way, any objects that you want to change or resize, you can simply click on them, and then in the upper right corner, there'll be this little drag and drop arrow right there, so you can make them larger or smaller, and then drag and drop your icons around here. So we'll make these a tiny bit smaller. And now he's really thinking about ice cream, all just hanging up by his head. All right, so we got say hi, thinking. One other thing before I rearrange some of the stuff down here, you can also edit the animations of how they move in and out. Let me explain. So you'll notice as he comes in, it kind of gives that bounce effect. If you wanted to do something else, you could do the in effect. You can change it to instant, where instead of him bouncing in, he's just boom, he's instantly there. Or we could change it to something like fade in, and you'll notice it's not a bounce, he just kind of fades in. So you can do that with both your in and out effects. So if you decide there's something else you want him to do, take a look through those. All right, so that's pretty good as far as that goes. Let's say when he starts thinking, that's where the ice cream is going to fade in. So I know he starts thinking about here by the way this track is set up. So we'll go ahead and move some of this ice cream stuff around so that it kind of matches up with that. And now our next step, we can add in some text. So as you can see by the text, each of these texts has a different animation. If you hover your mouse over it, it'll show you kind of what that text does. So you can decide if that's something that's going to work for you or not. So we'll go ahead and like grab this one. You just click on it, and then you're going to come over here. This is where you're going to add in your actual text. So if I do it like that, and then you can change the color of your text right here. And then you can also, whoops, I totally clicked the wrong thing. Where'd it go? There we go. All right, and then you can also select, you know, what font you'd like to use there. So let's say that's good. Increase the font size a little bit. And then this is where you can add an underlay to it. So you'll up the underlay opacity, which means this in the background. So if you need to make your text show up kind of a little bit more, that might be the way to do it. You'll see that makes it stick out just a bit more there. And then we'll add another one down here. Ice cream on a beach. And red, color 2, black. I know, that looks a little bit weird for just hanging out on a beach, but that's okay, it's just an example. There. Okay. All right, so let's get an idea of what that looks like here. You can see my little ice cream is fading in around his head. Perfect. All right. And I think those ice creams faded out a little bit early. So we're going to come up here. And like I told you earlier, you can grab and extend any of these out to any length that you want. So we'll go ahead and do that now, like so. And like so. So that'll line up our stuff a little bit better. Now the last thing, we can add some audio in here. So you can come through, you can play any sample by just clicking this button here. Hear what it sounds like. That sounds, I mean, that'll work for me, but you can run through these tracks, pick out any one you want. All you're gonna do, once you've got one picked out, is grab this, just drag and drop into the music column that you see right here, and that'll add the music into it. Now, when we play it, you'll notice that the music kind of starts in a little bit better. Like there's a little bit of an intro in the music. If you want your music to come in at a different point, so say we don't want the intro there, you can literally just drag this to a better part in the song. So now instead of having that fade in on the music, perfect. Alrighty, and then the final thing, once you've got everything in place, you've got your audio, you've got the text you want, you've got a background, you've got a nice scene, you may want to add a voiceover to it. Now, luckily, you can do this right within the application, which is really nice. All you need to do is come down to where voiceover is at, and then you'll hit this microphone icon. It'll count down to 3, and then it'll let you start recording. When you're done, you go ahead and hit the microphone again, and it will stop recording. So let's go ahead and hit that. This is Tom. He was hanging out at the beach. So there you go. Obviously that's not a very good commercial, but I just wanted to give you guys a sample of it. That's pretty much the basics. Once you've got a video that you're actually happy with, you'll come up here, you'll hit export. You can choose what resolution you want, 4K, 2K, 1080, whatever it may be. Select what quality you want. So the quality will affect the file size. If you want a little bit smaller file, you'll just pick something like that and it'll kind of auto select some options for you to give it a little bit smaller file size. Then you can choose the format right here. Little tip, most anything on the internet is going to be MP4 at this point. YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, all of those, they all use MP4, so that's probably the format that most everybody is going to go with. There's probably not really much of a reason to do anything else. Final thing, once you've got a project that you're happy with, you'll go ahead and hit the save button. And then we'll go back to my Toonly videos and you can see your video is saved right here. Little thing I missed at the beginning, when you first get into Toonly, you get this screen, so you just hit create new video first, but we started out in this dashboard. And that's basically the gist of it. That's just about how easy it is to use Toonly. Let's go ahead and expand this back up. We're kind of done with Toonly. So yeah, it's really simple. I think that this is a great tool. I tried to find some statistics on how well cartoon marketing videos actually work. I couldn't find any actual statistical numbers of how they compare to, say, regular videos. We do know that as far as in marketing, videos do work better than text and pictures. And they do know that some of these cartoons tend to get more attention just because it's a little bit more lighthearted. It appeals to that Saturday morning kid that's in all of us that wants to watch cartoons. So my own personal experience with it, I was using text ads at first on Facebook to try to get some attention. I would say I was lucky to get maybe 5% engagement. I wasn't getting a whole lot of response from what I was putting out there. Since making the cartoon ads, I've added almost 100 followers to my Facebook, and I'm getting on average probably around 25% engagement, sometimes a little more, sometimes a little less, depending on the ad. So it does get really good engagement. I'm pretty pleased with the response. So I definitely recommend using cartoons in your marketing, and I think this is going to be an awesome tool to help people out with being able to make those cartoons without spending a ton of money. Usually most of these cartoons I've seen, they charge at minimum $100 for maybe a couple minute video, on up from there. So if you need to make anything that's lengthy, you're gonna spend a lot of money. Whereas Toonly, I think right now the plans are $20 a month or a little bit more depending on what you go with. I did go with the enterprise plan. I do recommend the enterprise plan because you get a lot of extra assets. Having more characters and backgrounds and stuff available will make it a little bit easier to produce your video. Other than that, that's about all there is to know about Toonly. There's a lot of great videos on the Toonly website. I'll drop a link where you can purchase an Toonly in the video description. Other than that, if you have any other questions, like I said, you can check out Toonly's site, but feel free to reach out to me as well. You can leave a comment and I will respond to it, or feel free to shoot me an email, thomas@easyweb101.com, or you can also hop on our Facebook, EasyWeb101 on Facebook, or EasyWeb101.com. Go to the site and submit through the contact form. Whatever your preference is, go ahead and hit us up. We'll be happy to answer any questions that we can help you with. Other than that, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video and share, and we'll see you next time.